Ready? Begin.
QPV TV. Stand by for live.
Going live.
We are go for spinning flag.
Flag is spinning.
Merc!
Stand by with Panther Roar.
Panther Roar is active.
QPV TV live is on in 3, 2, 1.
What's up, Corona?
I know, you've missed us, and we really missed you, too.
Coming up on the show today, we have an inside look at boys basketball and girls water polo.
And we'll get up close and personal with the directors for the Sooner Productions. And we also have a very exclusive phone interview with Super Bowl champion and Corona High alumni, Heath Farwell. So you guys really want to stick around for that.
Please rise and join us for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Ready? Begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You know what sport is having a great season?
No, please tell me.
Boys basketball. They've done great so far. Their secret must be the amazing new pep band. The team won the Big Daddy tournament for the second year in a row. They put away Santiago and they're gunning for Roosevelt tonight.
I'm totally going to go to that game. Are you?
Yep.
Got to support the Panthers. But that takes a lot of talent to do that, which I don't think you have, bro. So anyways, let's get to that video by Isaiah Alexander.
I do it.
Water polo team filmed by Casey Greenberg.
Wow, that looked really good. Let's swing it outside to our PCTV correspondent, Joe Badawi, to fill us in on the student drama productions. Take it away, Joe.
Hello, all you internally beautiful PCTV viewers. I'm Joe Badawi, and I'm here with Jocelyn Zaragoza and Raphael. They are both directors of different plays in the student production, and they're here to tell us what it's all about.
So our show is The Great Pandemonium, and it's directed by Hannah Sullivan and I. And it's a high school theater. The show is about the high school theater putting on a Richard III show. And it's just totally crazy. The show is like the actors are falling off stage. The director's trying to direct everything and nothing goes right. But it's all a happy ending, so it's all good.
And you guys do everything in this by yourself, no help from any adult at all.
Well, we try to do as much as we can by ourselves, but we're always going to need some help. We got some help from Mr. Ballard, so a lot of thanks to him, some help from Mrs. Eden, and also from Mrs. Brocky, so we're pretty grateful about all of them.
Does it cost money, or do we have to, like, do a special dance for you? Like, how do we get into the play?
Well, it costs money to go see it. It's next Thursday, and, I mean, it's also almost May, not just The Great Pandemonium. It's $5 at the door, and it's two shows for one, so it's a good price, and it's really good, because Valentine's Day is, like, and their show is a love story, so it fits really good.
All right, I'm done here. Back to you, Nick.
Thanks, Joe. Now we have a PZTV exclusive interview with Heath Farwell, number 55 on the Super Bowl champion Seattle Seahawks. He was even their special teams captain. Heath graduated here in 2000 and was kind enough to grant us this very special interview.
Heath wanted us to tell you that he appreciates all the support he got from the CHS family, especially from ASB and Nicole Blanchett, who hung a 10-foot jersey outside his parents' house on Super Bowl Sunday.
Where do you find a jersey like that?
Target? Maybe Walmart?
Yeah, could be one of those. But let's get to that video.
Speaker right there.
Hello.
Hey, Heath.
How you doing?
Hey, Chris Peterson. How you doing, man?
Good. How's it going?
Good. Hey, thank you so much for taking this call and for doing this for us. That's awesome. I have Isaiah Alexander with me. He's one of my students, and we are recording this for PZTV. It's Panthers on Television. So I'm going to hand you off here in just a minute, and then it will be Isaiah taking over, okay?
Perfect. Thank you.
All right. Thank you.
It's an honor to be speaking with you today, and I just want to ask, how you doing today?
Good. How you doing, man?
I'm doing fine. You know, I see you around the weight room whenever you come to visit Old Corona High, and man, I can't believe it. You went to the Super Bowl as an underdog, and you managed to beat the Broncos, but not only beat, but dominate. So I just got to ask my first question. How does it feel to be a Super Bowl champion?
It's an unbelievable feeling. You know, I've been playing football a long time, 9 years in the NFL, so I realized the magnitude of this game and how hard it is to get to that game and actually win that game. I know a lot of players and you know, friends of mine and guys that you've watched on TV over the years that have played, you know, 10, 15 years and never get an opportunity to do that. And, you know, so I know the significance of it. And it's just special. It's special for Seattle, you know, the state of Washington, the Pacific Northwest is, you know, the support they give us, you know, with the 12th man and just the following we have, it's unbelievable. So it's just something special for the city, you know, the state of Washington, just all the followers we have. It's special. You know, like you said, the first Super Bowl in franchise history. It's special.
Wow. So let's go back to 2000 when you were just a high schooler playing for Corona High. How did playing for a football team prepare you for your professional football career?
I mean, I think football in general, you know, it you know, not only does it help, you know, help you you know, mature as a young guy, but I think it just helps you know, just it brings you along, brings around. You know, I have a lot of great friends back from high school. You know, in Corona High School, learning under Steve Hill was, you know, he was such an inspiration to me and kind of encouraged me to go on to play, you know, believed in me, encouraged me to go on to play college football and to give it a shot. And, you know, so yeah, I owe a lot to him. He was a big part in that. So, yeah, like I said, I thank him as much as I can, just because he believed in me. He gave, you know, inspired me to further my career on to go on to play at San Diego State.
That's great. Great. Is there any advice that you can give to Corona High football right now?
The advice I could give is, you know, don't believe what you're hearing. You know, you know, it's not where you start, it's where you finish. And if you guys believe in each other, you know, believe in the program, believe in what your coach Coach Hill is doing, I think you guys can turn it around and turn it into a championship program. And I think you just got to believe it. You know, and a good example is when I first got here to Seattle. You know, we were 8-8, and you know, there was we were just a young team that you know, kind of like you guys, just a young team that had a lot of promise. But you know, nobody on the outside knew that, but we believed it, and we saw the if we worked hard, we could, you know, do some big things, and we came up close last year, and we learned a lot. You know, a lot of these guys had never played in a playoff game, and you know, we went to the divisional round and came up a little short, but we left that game thinking, you know, we were going to come back and do whatever it took to win the Super Bowl, and here we are sitting here, you know, hosting the Lombardi Trophy. It's a dream come true, but I think it has a lot to do with, you know, guys just believing in what we do. Believing in Coach Carroll, believing in the program, and so, like I said, believing in each other.
Okay. Thank you, Heath. All right, I just want to say, on behalf of everybody from PZTV, we thank you for your time. Everybody, that was Heath Farwell, Corona High alumni, Seattle Seahawk, and now Super Bowl champion. Thank you, Heath. Thank you.
Thank you very much, and go Hawks, and go Panthers.
Thanks for that, Isaiah, and a very special thank you. And Panthers, congrats to you, Heath Farwell.
You made your fellow Panthers proud.
Sadly, that's all the time we have for now. Join us next time. For all of us here at PZTV, I'm Nick.
And I'm Nolan. Have a great day, Corona.
Good job. That was fun. Yeah.